In this problem, we've got a large fire sprinkler that's anchored to a wall. It sprays water out uniformly in all directions away from the wall. So from this angle, what happens is the water will flow down the sprinkler head and then outward in that direction, in directions parallel to the wall, and in a direction that comes straight out from the wall. If we look straight downward on it, the fluid flows into the screen, and then it's turned, again, in all directions from this perspective, both parallel to the wall and normal to the wall. From the perspective in the upper right, the fluid is flowing both left and right, and at this location, it's coming out straight at us. Let's define some coordinate axes. We'll have x coming out straight out from the wall, we'll have y coming out to the right, and z in the upward direction. We can see these same coordinate axes in different perspectives. What we're being asked to find are the x, y, and z components of any anchoring force that's needed to hold the sprinkler in place. To visualize the anchoring force, I like to think about the sprinkler being glued to the wall, maybe. And we're looking at the force of the glue on the sprinkler head. And in turn, that represents the force of the sprinkler head on the water. If we looked at the sprinkler head on its own, the glue would be located on the back of the sprinkler head, so in this red region in the back of it here. And what I want you to envision is whether or not the glue will supply a force in the upward direction along the sprinkler head. Will it apply a force maybe outward, or would it be pulling the sprinkler head back into the wall? And if there would be any force left or right from the glue acting on the sprinkler head. To get at this question, I want you to think about the direction in which the water is flowing into the sprinkler head. So it's flowing down this upper portion of the sprinkler head, and then it's fanned out in all directions. It may be easier to see this with a section view. We see from the side the fluid will flow downward and then it's turned at the bottom of it and fanned out in the other two directions. What I want you to think about first is the x component of this anchoring force, so the direction normal to the wall. Is there an anchoring force in that direction, a component of anchoring force in that direction? And if there is, does that force act into the wall? So in the negative x direction, does it act in the positive x direction, which is out of the wall, or is it zero? So to answer this question, I look at the rate at which any x component of momentum is entering the control volume. And the entrance to the control volume will be right in this highlighted region here. And what we see is that there is no x component of momentum entering the control volume at that location. All of the momentum is in the negative z direction at the entrance of it. However, at the exit of the control volume, so the exit of our sprinkler head around the front face of it, there is an x component of momentum, and it acts in the positive x direction. So with that in mind, there does have to be a component of the anchoring force that acts in the positive x direction, or out of the wall. And that component of the anchoring force turns the fluid from being directly downward to some direction out of the wall. The next question I have for you is whether or not there's any y component of anchoring force. And if there is, does it act in the negative y direction to the left or in the positive y direction to the right? So the way to think about this is the fact that there is no y component of momentum entering the control volume. It's all in the negative z direction. However, there is a positive y component of momentum leaving on this portion of the sprinkler head, suggesting that there might be an anchoring force that has to act to the right. However, there's also a component of momentum acting in the negative y direction, and they're equal and opposite. And it turns out that the net effect is that there is no y component of momentum leaving the control volume. So we have no y component entering and no y component leaving, which means that the y component of the anchoring force must be equal to zero. And lastly, I want you to think about any z component of anchoring force. Does it act upward? Is there any? Or does it act downward in the negative z direction? Well, to answer this question, we do have a z component of momentum that's entering the control volume, and it's entering in the negative z direction. However, there is no z component of momentum leaving the control volume. It all fans out with a velocity that has no z component. Therefore, we've got a negative z component of momentum entering the control volume, none leaving, and there must be an upward component of force acting on the sprinkler. In other words, the glue on the back of that sprinkler prevents it from flying into the ground. And the glue acts upward